woman is at 9:25 tonight. This is BBC One.
Good evening. Well, whilst we've been cooped up inside for most of the day, outside it's been glorious. Glorious enough for the vagabonds, that was them you just saw now, to go dancing in the street.
I must just say before I go that Group Captain Bardo has asked Terry Madden to take him up at 1,000 miles an hour. Till next week, goodbye.
Tonight, loquaciously lugubrious Leonard Sack.
For God's sake, don't open your mouth. Now let's hear a girl who's a sort of... You're all right, don't open your mouth, right. Will you? Here's a girl who's a sort of Irish ambassadress of song, singing Come Back and Shake Me, Clodagh Rodgers. Thank you very much indeed. Lovely girl. Super singer too, Clodagh Rodgers.
Time for Talk Back.
Good evening. In your television correspondence column tonight, an audience of under 25s talking back after last week's programme, the latest Beatle beta, Quinton Hogg, on who speaks for the younger generation, and almost inevitably, how to speak to the Foreign Secretary without getting involved with George. But first, take a look at this new sound.
It's 1 o'clock.
The voice of Radio World.
It's the Dave Cash Show.
Just for fun.
Music.
Too much.
And thank you very much. We're here with you till 2 o'clock, so hang on. To start things off, these are the box tops, the letter.
Give me a ticket for an aeroplane. Ain't got time to take a fast train. Lonely days are gone, I'm a-going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. I don't care how much money I gotta spare. Got to get back to my baby.
That's the box tops and the letter to open things up for you.
Radio One, good time music. Right!
Right, and it is 3 minutes past the hour of 1 o'clock on a Monday afternoon. Bit of Jesse James music.
Jesse James rides again!
You said that, baby.
Taking the week overall, Radio 1 and Radio 2 are broadcasting for a total of 142 hours, and for 86 of these hours, they're broadcasting the same programme.
And now this year's Royal Variety Performance. Part 1, about to begin, is a little longer than published, and Part 2 will follow the news, which will now be at 9:30. And because of this, programmes afterwards will also be running late, Horse beginning now at 10:45, and Meeting Point at 11:35.
This is BBC One.
Good evening. This is BBC Two. My name is Dennis Toohey, and this is the lineup studio from which, all being well, BBC programmes, BBC Two programmes, will start each evening from now on. And first of all, let me introduce you to some of the elements that go to make up the new service. This is the identification symbol, the hallmark, that you'll be seeing regularly in one form or another. This end of the studio will be used from time to time to keep you in touch with what's happening and what's going to happen. And over there, back there behind the slats and in control of the whole operation, is the production gallery. Now I'd like you to meet the lineup team. First of all, my fellow anchorman, John Stone.
As the dark minutes ticked by in the studio last night, I ignored the merry cries of, Bert's pulled the wrong plug, or Charlie's put the mockers on again.
Fairly soon, but making very slow progress indeed further south. On to tomorrow's chart then, and the cold front in the North Sea, but still rather ineffective, but over somewhere in western districts of Wales. On to tonight's chart now then, and for much of Scotland and Northern Ireland, a clear night and a dry night, and later on some fog patches developing. But for southern Scotland and much of England and Wales, a cloudy night, misty, hill fog about, and some rain and drizzle, some of it rather heavy now in western areas, and in northern districts, but eventually becoming fairly light later in the night. And then on tomorrow's chart, well, England and Wales, again, rather cloudy, still some mist about, possibly some bright intervals in places, and mainly dry. Scotland and Northern Ireland, mainly dry there too, and some sunny intervals after the clearance of the morning fog. Still mild in northern and western areas, still rather cold in the east and the southeast. And that's all the weather for now.
For a secret never to be told. It's a wish and not a kiss. Ten is a bird you must not miss. It's a wish and not a kiss. Ten is a bird you must not miss.
Hello and welcome to the Thursday Magpie Show, the Easter Magpie Show, no less. I'm up in a part of the building where unauthorised persons are strictly prohibited to go. In fact, I shouldn't be here at all. I'm surrounded by very sophisticated technical television equipment, the reason for which you'll find out later in the show. But right now, Tony is down in the studio looking absolutely devastating in what could be the latest gear from Carnaby Street. That's not what it is. Should we go down and find out exactly what he is wearing?
They can hang him while they're waiting to eat them. Anyway, let's try this. I have no idea what it's going to taste like. I'm not too sure if I'm going to like it or not, but here we go. One instant strawberry cube coming out. It's packed in very tightly. Out it comes.
Well, it tastes like strawberries. As a matter of fact, it's not bad. The other thing is it costs 50 times as much as it would cost here on Earth. I think I'll eat the rest of this and put things over to Sue at the moment.
Personally, I'd rather have some fish and chips, a nice cup of tea. Well, I'm still up in VTR, I'm not in Cape Canaveral, to find out exactly what those three little letters mean. Be back in a couple of minutes.
Magpie.
The other thing I need, which is very important, is a microphone, because we're recording sound as well. And at this very moment, what I'm saying is going onto the tape, and what Tony is seeing is going onto the tape, and you can see what Tony's seeing on the monitor down there. I think we've recorded enough now. You're keeping me in nicely. Right. Now we'll stop it. Rewind again. Beginning. Now it'll take a second or two for the tape to get to the right speed, so the picture will flicker a little bit while we're starting this up. And here it comes. The other thing I need, which is very important, is a microphone, because we're recording sound as well. And at this very moment, what I'm saying is going onto the tape, and what Tony is seeing is going onto the tape.
Right, well, that's how we get our pictures
on the monitor down there.
Onto tape. But, of course, in the studio, we use much bigger equipment and much more expensive and sophisticated equipment to record the programs that we want to record here at Thames. So, what we'll do is we'll go and join Sue, who is in the VTR room, or video tape recording room.
Well, you've seen the narrow tape for sound recording, and you've seen the slightly wider tape for a portable VTR machine. Now, this is the real McCoy. This, in fact, is the next piece of Magpie. It's a rather special VTR insert that I recorded this morning. And it's 2 inches wide, and it's very heavy. I'm going to give it to Ron, who's going to put it on now. You can probably hear in the background that they're recording a new Tommy Cooper show, and also someone do not adjust your set. I can hear in the background here. Anyway, it's lots of things happening. Let's go and see how Ron's getting on. How are we doing?
Almost there.
Just like a large tape recording machine, isn't it?
Yeah, just wind it on. There we are, we're ready.
Tell me, if you were recording an hour and a half play, how big a spool would you need? How many spools would you need?
Just the one, this one here, this big one. We're using a small one today, but it'd be the big one for the big show.
Just one big spool. Well, roll it away, they're probably waiting.
Here we go.
We had great fun this morning because when we were recording this VTR insert, we had lots of security men around the studio because we had a very important item that was priceless and we could only have for a short time.
35.
Coming up now on the clock, you'll hear a sound identification.
Magpie insert number 2, Fabergé egg item, VTR 1795B, take 1.
You hear it? Now, normally in the studio, I'd be having somebody in front of me counting me down so that I could stop talking at the right time, like this. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.